Who are you, Jerry? Say your
Jerry,
name.
Jerry Bohl, living out single.
Okay.
These are called honey supers. They're about 6.5 inches high, and they're called honey supers because these supers you can rot. We're not going to get into it. We will get into it. And what I'm taking out here is called a frame. And a frame is what the bees store their honey in. That's an empty frame that I got honey out of this year. And there's 10 of these.
What do you do? You just scrape the honey off the...
Well, it's capped, and you cut it off, and then you put it in this thing here called an extractor. And you set them in there like this and spin it. There's a handle right here where you spin it, and centrifugal force throws the honey out of the cells against here, fills up the bottom. You take it out of that little drain there. So there's 10 of those frames. And I got honey out of these about 2 months ago.
And those exact frames. That 10-frame unit, is that the standard unit?
Yes. Yep, sure is. That's called a super. Those are called honey supers. The shallow ones are called honey supers. If you keep it covered up like this, the mice can't get in. Because they're always looking for a free meal. And this is the lid. The smoker is just that. It smokes the bees. You introduce smoke into the hive, the bees stay calm. They actually think about eating instead of thinking about stinging. So that's what we want.
And you feed the smoker what? Just paper? What?
Start with paper. I'm using, you can use needles. These are Schumach cones. Oops.
Okay. Yep.
Schumach cones. We have a bunch of Schumach out there. Pick a pailful every year.
Yeah.
The whole idea is to get that Schumach on fire. It'll smolder and burn, and they like the odor, the aroma. So there's not much food out here anywhere. And just as a safeguard against starvation during the winter, it's a good idea to feed them so that they can either, one of two things, either they take some of this extra sugar water we're going to give them and literally make honey that they store for the winter, or the least they're going to do is not eat their stored food right now, they're going to eat the sugar water so that they'll have a good supply for the winter.
And you said the sugar water is 1-to-1, so
this is potent stuff. In the spring, it's two parts water, one part sugar.
Right.
But you're really interested in giving them all the energy that you can possibly give them right now. Then the other ones, these are like 9.5. The other ones are like 5.75. And this is their, you never take them off. That's their house. First thing you want to do is smoke them a little bit. Let them know that something's going to happen. There's a reducer in the front of that natural pine board.
So they like the smoke a little bit. They kind of like that.
And this time of year, you want to... That opening is ordinarily this high, up to here and all the way across. They've got that glued in now.
Okay.
But if you leave it like that, this time of year, mice will get in there. So you put this reducer in here.
Right here, this pine piece.
Got it.
Yeah, so you reduce the openings so mice can't get in it. That's the purpose of that. There's a bunch of different job descriptions with bees. Bees last maybe 3-4 weeks in the summertime. They fly them, wear themselves out flying. And when they're first hatched, they stay in the hive and do domestic work. Clean the cells, transfer. The pollen and nectar from the bees, take it up to the cells. You want to keep in mind that everything in a hive is done in the dark. That's their normal operating area, is in the dark. There's no light getting in this hive, and that's normal. There doesn't have to be any light getting in the hive for them to operate. It's any more than in a tree. I'm doing a little experiment here with this wood chip stuff. It's to keep the condensation that would form on the inside of the lid I just took off. When you get condensation in there, and then when it melts or drips, it drips right down on the bees, and in cool weather, that's real hard on them.
Yeah.
It's very hard on them. So what we're looking at here is the top of the hive, and this is the bag that I put in there 2 days ago. And there's just a little bit of honey in here, and I'll leave that down here. And they'll get in there, and they'll find a way to get that out of there. But these are the frames. We're going to start on the outside and take a look, take the outside frame off, take a look at what we have here. There's 10 of these frames in here. Somebody smarter than me a long time ago, these are called, this is a Langston beehive. And anything 3/8 of an inch or smaller, a bee will not build comb in. If there's more of a gap in here than 3/8 of an inch, they'll build comb in. And what we want to do is take a look and see what we have here. We got some bees here that are kind of interested, so I might get stung a little bit. I don't know. They're a little feisty. Did you see the capped honey here?
Oh, yes.
And this is the outside frame. This would be the last one that they fill up.
Oh, yeah.
See that? That's a good thing. I don't know, you're not going to, I don't know what you got for light here, but.
I can open up this pretty good.
Why don't you can get right over here, get over here on this side. It's better if you're on that side away from the light path. See where they're all gathering, when they flew out, see where they're all gathering right here?
Yep.
You just don't want to be in their traffic lane.
Okay.
This is one of the inner cones. And what I'm looking for here is I'm looking, these brown dark caps covered are larvae. Yeah, you see the ones here, they haven't capped them yet?
Yes.
They'll come back and cap them pretty soon. But this will be the last birthing round this year.
Okay.
And what I'm seeing is that I was in this hive about a week and a half ago, and this was all busy with capped brood. Now, from my hive tool here, they're building it up to see where the honey's in there.
Can you see that shiny stuff in here,
yep.
Pete?
Yep.
They're starting to fill up that area, which is what we want. I'm looking for eggs, and it's a good thing. I'm not finding eggs. That's perfect. Life is good. But I am finding some cat brood and some larvae right in here that hasn't been capped yet, but I don't see any new eggs in there. That means the queen has stopped laying, and she should have stopped laying this time of year. She senses when things are getting slow,
uh-huh.
The temperature change, the light, the time of year, and so she automatically stops laying eggs.
Yeah.
She will control the population in the hive by her egg production. That's the bottom line.
Now, how often do you apply the smoker? How do you judge when to do that?
When they appear to be getting a little nervous.
Ah.
And right now, they're absolutely dead calm.
Yeah.
If you look over here, you'll see this area here, from here on out,
yep.
In the cells. They're filling that up with nectar. Over here, too. They've reduced the area where the brood was. You can see that there's a little bit of cap brood in here. These brown cells. That'll be the last ones for the year. The queen will literally stop laying, so the bees, as they get older, will die and they won't be replaced until spring. Most of the bees that we see here will not live till spring. They'll die sometime during that cycle.
Uh-huh.
And she'll lay some more eggs in mid-December. And it takes 21 days for them to hatch. So it'll be the middle of January when those hatch, and the hive will have gone down to, say, 5,000-6,000 bees, the population, and that new generation that comes out in January then will be the ones that will take over for next year. But there's some nice weight to this. It's only about 30% full of honey. And we want it a little bit fuller, so I'm going to feed them. And that's why I'm feeding them. Because there's nothing left here, and these guys got to eat. They're going to do one of two things. Either eat this, or eat the sugar water that I give them.
Uh-huh.
And you see, if you're saying, geez, Jerry, looks like you're being a little reckless here. I'm not. This is really all the more careful you have got to be. Just be slow. And you can see that they're having a good hair day. Everybody's busy doing something. You see the pattern of food here?
Yes.
It's even more crowded?
Yes.
We move these out of the way. You see this here? Look at this. There's very few brood in there. Excuse me. And that's what you want. If you smoke them like this, they'll move away a little bit on their own. I was blowing on them, but... See, I don't see any new brood in there. I only see... cells that are getting filled up with sugar. That's what we want, with honey. They won't take the sugar water that we're feeding it and feeding them today and put it in there. They'll turn it into honey.
Uh huh.
But that's just what you want. Where's the queen? Someone might ask. I have no idea.
Yeah.
I've seen her 2 or 3 times this year. She's very elusive.
So she moves around in there randomly?
Yeah. And generally, there's a group of bees that stay with her. This is good to be able to have to do this. See this one? Look at this one here. Take with your naked eye. See all that?
Yep.
Right here? That's just exactly what you want, man. There's going to be lots of food in here. And if I feed them, and this is one of the innermost, see this one here?
Yes.
All right. These are the ones that would be full from the, they start from the center and work out. Always start from the center and work out.
Okay.
So because that one is nice and full, I'm going to take it and put it out here. And they'll finish filling that up. But the outside ones are the ones that are have the least amount of honey in them. Oops. And they'll get in there and work on those. I'll do the same thing to the other side. Take the outside frames, depending on what they look like. Oh, that's what you want. See that? See the cells here that aren't full?
Yes.
But look at this side.
Big difference.
Yeah. See, it's all cat. That's their winner. That's their winter food right there. I'll just turn that one around a little bit. I'm trying to move things in this super. Judy and I were in them about every 3 days. I mean, we would sit here and pick one of these frames and watch them and look at them and watch the queen deposit eggs and then go to a different frame and watch the. Because when they are born, they start, the bee is in there, head up, and he starts eating the little wax off, and then it gets bigger, and it takes about 5-7 minutes for him to get that wax eaten off the top of the cone, the cell, and then out he comes. And he's stumbling around like a little colt in the field, you know, just fascinating. The evolution of watching that stuff happen is real therapeutic. The other day when I did that, about 4 or 5 bees stumbled on that, and they were eating, drinking out just like a...
Okay, so we're showing them the sugar water here now, and Jerry's just cut this
There's plastic. One they're eating. What, two of them now?
And they need this, and so that's the... this is not just to go play. This is actually important for them. And they seem to be going for it.
Oh, yeah. The word's out now.
Yeah.
They have a way of communicating, and we can come back in 10 minutes and there'll probably be 200 bees up here. The word's out, man. The fat guy's fed us. And okay. All their communication is done in the dark. They must have excellent night vision or something. I got one on my neck.
Now, we're in southern Michigan here, or western Michigan actually, fairly close to the lake, so... Next spring, when approximately will you be able to cease feeding them the sugar water and they go back?
I'm only going to feed them till the middle of November. See in there, that new nectar that's in there, new sugar honey, and these frames that we saw along here that were rock solid full.
They're good to go.
I'm excited.
Okay.
2 weeks ago, this wasn't the case. There was still enough out there. Okay. And 2 weeks ago, I'm going to say there was twice as many bees in this hive. It was amazing. There's been a dramatic reduction just through, we'll call it attrition, but it isn't really attrition because they're dying. Yeah. They're not retiring.
Yeah. No such thing, huh?
Yeah. And that's part of the natural process.
Sure. Cool. This is really neat.
It is cool, isn't it? Yeah. It's just amazing. I bring the grandkids out here and they get close and I dress them up in a white shirt and a this is not really the best of garb. Black or dark colors that piss them off.
Does it?
The white colors.
They're happy with me.
Well, they're not bothering me even, but lighter colors are less alarming to them. That's it.